the Dance by Henry Livingston. Take the name of the swain, a forlorn, witless elf, who was changed to a flower for admiring himself. A part deem'd essential in each lady's dress, with what maidens cry when they wish to say yes. A lullaby carriage, soft, cozy, and light, with the name of the poet who sang on the night. The Queen of Cairo, all lovely and winning, whose blandishments ever kept Antony grinning. The flower, whose odours unremittingly please, with the glory of forests, the king of the trees. To the prince of the fairies, a jealous old knave, put the name of the tree that undid Mother Eve. To finish the whole, add that period of day when the linnet and thrush to repose hie away. The initials of these, if adjusted with care, will show you the fairest where thousands are fair. The sweet, pretty graces still hover about her, and Cupid would die with vexation without her. When she swims in the dance, or wherever she goes, she's crowded by witlings, plain fellows, and beaux, who throng at her elbow and tread on her toes. If a pin or a handkerchief happen to fall, to seize on the prize fills with uproar the hall. Such pulling and hauling and shoving and pushing as rivals the racket of key and the cushion. And happy, thrice happy, too happy, the swain who can replace the pin or bandana again. Though the fellows surround and so humbly adore her, the girls, on the contrary, cannot endure her. Her beauty, their beauty, forever disgraces, and her sweeter face still eclipses their faces. For no lovely girl can a lovely girl bear, and fair ones are ever at war with the fair.